Welcome to Platform Media International Political Arena. I'm yours sincerely, Joe Ehizode. All of you must have heard the political reverberation coming from Edo State of Nigeria. Election was conducted and there were fears that the election was going to be violent. But the cynics were disappointed. And the positive people who are positive were vindicated, and elections in Edo State was conducted. It was assumed to be free and fair, and a victor emerged. And there were those who lost the election. The good thing about it all is that it was a fight, as some people will put it, between David and Goliath. And my friend who is in the studio tonight, Mr. Ebenezer Badewa, we want to confirm whether this was a fight between David and Goliath or it was a level playing field. Mr. Badewa, welcome to the studio, sir.
Thank you for having me, Joe.
Well, Badewa, not many would have thought that because of the political machines against the incumbent governor of Edo State, Mr. Godwin Obaseki, not many would have thought that he would survive, not to talk of winning the election, because many things were against him. Federal might, the power of godfathers, and for the fact that he was not politically known before he was made a governor 4 years ago. Every indication points to the fact that he was going to be the one who will lose. Mr. Avendi Abadewa, give me your perspective about this.
thank you very much. Yeah, it's true. It's possible for a candidate or a person to be in an office unknown, unpopular, but the productivity, you see, they said a good product doesn't need too much advertisement. So Obaseki, within the 4 years, as if he actually knew what was coming towards him, has been able to prove himself to the Edo people that he's governor of the people, not governor of a political party. And the working, though he might not, as of today, maybe he might not have touched every area that some people expect him to, but he was running an open government. He was running an open government as in his own side, on the matter he worked to protect himself in office, just like the excuse that Tinubu used, that he refused to swear in some member of House of Assembly. But other than that, this man worked with the people, you know, and the people see him working, and this is why they supported him. And this election is not it's not about party, because by all definition, he's not supposed to even made it to PDP. But you see, the PDP, they recognize a good product, not just only him, they even absorb his deputy too. And those who were supposed to be their candidate, they settled out of a court and they allow him to run. And the people, they supported him. I think Governor Obaseki has proved that if you serve the people will surely stand behind you.
So you mentioned that it's a good product. That was why he was elected. Now, yes. The question arises that if you cross from APC to PDP within a fortnight of you being disqualified in the APC, you move over for PDP. So is he going to run on PDP programs, or is he going to run on his own program or the APC ideology. There's a confusion here, Mr. Badewa.
Gone are those days that Nigerian political party has what we call political ideology or manifesto. I think sometime on this platform, maybe a few years ago before the 2019 election, we already said it, that the two political parties, the major two political parties in Nigeria, they have no ideology, they have no anything like even manifesto to start with, not to talk of an ideology, compared to the one we used to have during the Second Republic, or compare them to what is happening in Western world. So this is why it's easy for them to cross carpet between both political parties. When you go there, monkey see, monkey do. That's what most of them does, right? So there's nothing like an ideology. So that was why it was very easy for him to cross carpet, just like many of them too, who has been cross carpeting here and there. So there's no any political ideology look at even the president himself. You know how many political party he has formed or established before he became APC a candidate? And within APC now, you know, there are different factions in within APC. So there is no any ideology anywhere. So this is even a very open book for him now to just serve the people. Any program, anything that you know the people of Edo State need, do it for them as the money, as long as you can fund them. That's it. There's no any ideology in the country.
So does this portend good governance for Edo State? Because now I saw him celebrating. One of the issues he raised is that there won't be anybody who will be dictating to him to say you choose this commissioner or choose these advisors. But again, the fear is that if there's nobody to checkmate you, that might lead to dictatorship.
No,
which is better? Which one comes better for Edo State citizens?
The leadership that were dictated to them, you know, if you remember what happened to Ambode got in, and he found out that the structure, the party structure they have in there, it's a barrier, it's an obstacle for a good governance. And he decided to serve the people of Lagos State. What happened at the end of the day? They said he's a very hardworking governor, but he's not a party man. In what we're facing in Nigeria now, do we want a party man or want somebody that will work for the people? You know, we want people that work for the people, not somebody that work for the political party. Just like Obaseki in his 4 years, some of his commissioner or some of his advisors, they get some of their contractor by the roadside. People who they know that this guy know what he's doing, they called him, listen, so-so-so school need number of so-so-so shares. How much will it cost you to do it, and how long can you get it done? They bypass all the middlemen, the political jobbers who will collect contract for maybe 10 million and spend maybe less than 5 million to 1 million to get the job done. And that's if the job is even get done at all. So these are some of the things that work for Obaseki. So now, when there is no political party to dictate to him, like he said, I think he's telling the people that I'm accountable to you. I'm accountable to the people.
Mr. Badewa, in your widest imagination, do you think this would have been possible 4 years ago with the political machine that Tinubu has, the political power that our network that Oshomole, Comrade Oshomole had? What do you think, apart from being the good person, what did you think was the reason why Governor Obaseki was able to come out victorious despite the intimidating opposition in front of him?
You see, the people themselves, they are fed up of all this godfatherism. The moment Tinubu denied Ambode's second term, all in the name that he was not a party man, and the president begged him, and he refused to listen to anybody, and he did what he feels he has to do, he has lost the trust of the people. So Oshomole himself too, he too has crossed the boundary, because all he said about Ezeyamu 4 years ago, for him now, a man at his age, now trying to rewrite the wrong again, the people know when he was sincere, and the people know now when he's trying to brainwash them. So they just look at him that all this is about their own interest. This is not the interest of Edo people. For sure, if not for Oshomole, nobody know Obaseki. The deputy governor then, who has been with him for 8 years, who was former member of House of Assembly, but he's been in the political arena in Edo State for a long time. He denied all these people the chance of becoming a governor, only to pick Obaseki. And he said Obaseki is the brain behind the success of his government. And the people bought into it. Now, for you now to say, oh, he's not the man anymore, when they've seen what he has done within that 4 years, Oshomole too has also lost it. He has lost it in the federal level. He has, as a political party chairman, and even as a state, elder state man, he has lost everything. You know, he should just go and stay in his village there, enjoy the mansion that he built there, and just sit down and watch. That's what I would advise him. He has tried. He has tried in his own time.
Mr. Badiwa, do you even think that because of Oshomole's intervention, because in the politics of Edo State, Ezeyamu Amosemo is just an unfortunate candidate because he had people who are perhaps going by the polls that we saw in Edo State, who people did not like. Oshomole, for instance, was busy flexing muscles all over the place. And perhaps what Tinubu, the brokers that Ahmed Tinubu, Chief Alhaji Jagaban Tinubu, made few days to the election by instructing Edo, broadcasting instructing Edo citizens not to vote for their governor. Perhaps that did them in. Do you believe that?
Of course. Tinubu has forgotten that the people in the Western, the Nigerians anyway, followed his lead because they believe he has done a good job in Lagos State, able to hold it since 1999. Everything has been running, and the development of Lagos State, the improvement in the IGR and everything, they saw it as a good structure for a state to go by. And if this can be replicated in the federal level, that Nigeria might go somewhere, you know. And they followed him, they voted Buhari in, but everybody are crying now, particularly look at in the face of pandemic, why other states are looking for how other countries are looking for how to alleviate the pain and the suffering of the people. Nigerian government is increasing fuel rate and electricity, and even increasing the tax and everything. So automatically this government is no longer popular with the people. Now for Tinubu to come out and start dictating to Edo people, and even if Ezeyamu has run as his own man without all this godfather stepping out to campaign for him, maybe the fight would have been fierce than what it was. Because Ezeyamu is a Benin man, Obaseki is from Moredo too. So, I mean, it would have been a very good fight because Ezeyamu is even popular in the political arena. So, for these two people coming out, they kind of spoiled the whole thing for Ezeyamu. I feel very sorry for him. I think he's a nice guy, but unfortunately, if he has stayed put in PDP and didn't cross over, maybe this would have been his turn, because Obaseki then would have a popular political party platform to run on. But few months before the election, he crossed over from PDP to join APC. And now it gave Obaseki the opportunity to go to the other party. So I feel very sorry for him. This would have been his time to win the election. But the crossing has kind of finished him too for being inconsistent with his own stand in the choice of political party that he married.
Okay. Get this thing clear. What's your perspective about this political slogan? Edo not be Lagos. Edo not be Lagos. Because some people are getting this twisted. Is it the fact that Edo people hate Lagosians, or it is the fact that they are saying what happened in Lagos will not happen here?
That's it, right? Yeah, that's it. What happened in Lagos, where they throw Ambode out, they can't throw Obaseki out like that, because you agree that Ambode was a very hard-working governor, but he's not a party man. Now, Obaseki is a very hard-working governor, and the people want him. They don't expect you to throw it out and get your own party man that will be saying, hey, I made you the governor, then you have to answer it to me. Obaseki was able to disengage himself from Oshomole even within the first, second year of his tenure in office. So all these things work for him.
So could this be beginning of the end of Godfatherism in politics in Nigeria?
If Nigeria can borrow leave from this, and anyway, they already churned the Ankara and the and $2,000 and $4,000 from the opposing party to Obaseki. They did collect the money, they collected the Ankara, but many of them didn't vote for them. They were surprised, you know? So if Nigeria can understand now that, listen, there are some people that are out to work for you.
And well, there are some. Well, this fight against Godfather started in Akwa Ibom State. The former Akwa Ibom State governor decided to choose the president, his successor by himself. Akwa Ibomites refused to do that, and they elected the one they want. So, but why this Edo State own is peculiar, or yeah, somebody call it the peculiar mess.
Peculiar mess.
Why? Well, this is quite astounding is the fact that Obaseki had a very strong opposition in front of him, and he vanquished them. Alhaji Mohammed Bola Tinubu is there, Oshomole is there, and the federal might is there. And that's why Edo State election results reverberated across the country. Now, could this be, I just asked you whether this could be the end of it. We have one in Kwara State too, Alhaji Bosola Saraki. That one too was recently defeated in the 2018 or 2019 election, correct?
Yeah, so, that one is a different case. It is the federal might that got that one defeated in the state. Not that the people outrightly rejected him, but it's the federal might that they took down there. It's just like somebody saying that this guy from Kogi State won the election in Kogi State. He didn't win the election. Is the federal mind that worked for him? Or is it in the
Yaya Bello didn't win.
Yaya Bello, no. Or the Osun State election. We all saw all this federal mind. But what worked in Edo this time around is that the Edo people, they were prepared. They guided the election, and they positioned themselves very well. You see, there was no tension. There was no gunshot.
They defended their votes.
Look at so many people they arrested.
Citizenship arrest. And that's why perhaps that's why they call Edo State the heartbeat of the nation.
Of course, you know they have their slogan. Edo actually proved that they are senior. You know, they said when they come to your house, they are senior. When you come to them, they are senior. Yes, yes, and they have they prove it now. And I said kudos to them, because one of the most remarkable art that the most of the adult people put on was ability to spot where the vote snatcher, those people that were buying vote, the other from people from other part of the country who were coming to create problem in the state, they were able to arrest them or even nail them on the board before it even happened. So I say kudos to them, because Obaseki has surrendered the election to the people, and the people did they fought for their state, and that's it how is, it should
it's
be.
Also shocking to me that people from neighboring states actually came armed with stacked themselves up with money coming to Edo State to participate in election rigging, citizenship arrest. I saw on television people with sack of money, people with HELOC buses painted in police color that were arrested by the citizens. So Edo State citizens actually defended their vote, correct?
Yeah, that's what has been going on in many states, because there are most of these people that comes from other states. They cause chaos and so on, scare the people out. But this time around, the Edo people were equal to their plan. So they instead of them scaring the Edo people, the Edo people scared those people away.
So let me ask you something. We are talking about politics in Edo State, but we also know that the deputy to Obaseki, Chief Philip Shoaibu, is what I'll call a political figure in all of this. So are you sure that Obaseki will not be a godfather four years later?
No.
Philip Shoaibu.
You see, Obaseki cannot even be a godfather to Philip Shoaibu, because Philip Shoaibu is the politician there. Obaseki is a technocrat. Mm-hmm. If without Philip Shoaibu, the man like Philip Shoaibu, I think Obaseki would have been a runover in this election. But that guy, he knows the politics of Edo State from corner to corner. He understands the terrain all the way to federal level. So is the strategist in this election that took place. So Obaseki is a good leader, because a good leader listen to his electorate.
Okay.
And that's what Obaseki did, and things work out. If Obaseki has said, okay, this it has to be my way or no other way, it would have been a cheap runover.
So, judging by what you have seen since the election was, the election results came out, Obaseki came out victorious. Do you think Obaseki will be magnanimous, given what played out during the campaigns? There was so much rancor, there was so much bitterness. You think he will be magnanimous?
Oh, for sure. Yeah, I think there was a video or a news somewhere in the on social media, maybe yesterday or today. He has even called on Shomole, call on Eze Yamu, that this is their state. They have to build it together. They should come and build it together.
Yeah, with also another clip that I saw where he said, well, it would be nice to Obaseki, to Shomole, as long as he doesn't begin to engage in nefarious activities, trying to sponsor his lions and tigers in quote. Those are the kind of the talks. I think they gave themselves those names when they were preparing for elections. He said, as long as he does not fertilize the ideas of those talks, he will be nice to him. But for otherwise, he will be swift and he will be decisive. So it's like the battle line, he has drawn a line on the sand that Oshomole had to be careful, right?
Not necessarily a game online. He's sending a message to people like, is it Captain Okumbo or Edobo or whatever?
Who said and Kabaka. Kabaka and Co.
Yes, all those Agbero guys that they will spend their last cover to get Obaseki out of office. Obaseki is here to lead, to serve the people. So now that the election is over, everybody should just drop the weapon and work with him. He's the governor of Edo State elected now. So whether you vote for him or you didn't vote for him, currently he's the governor of Edo State. So people unite with him, they shouldn't cause any problem or try to instigate some member of House of Assembly still trying to give him some kind of political unrest, thinking that they can impeach him and other kind of stuff. They should stop and let Edo State, Edo is a kingdom. Edo State is a kingdom and it's a country, it's a state that we don't have to play politics with, because we are more or less like, Edo State is more or less like Nigeria.
And he is the chief security officer, so he has the constitutional powers to protect Edo State. So if anybody engages in any nefarious activity, he has the power to crush them. I think he has that power.
Yeah, he just sent a message to those guys that are following Obaseki. You know, over 40-something member of his personal staff. They left him to join up
Oshomole.
You know, so those kind of people, now they lost their source of income and source of influence. So they might want to create some trouble. They might still be saying they have some mathematics they can play in order to get him out of office. So it's warning all those people. I know Oshomole this time around will retire to his village and try to enjoy the rest of his life.
You think a politician will retire? Or you think like a phoenix, he will not come back again through another means?
No, Oshomole, his time is over. Federally, they already told him to go to his village and settle down.
And his village was suspended from his ward. So it means his political future of life is over.
He can be a good role model now. He can advise, he can create, if you want to build his image back again, let him get all those people that he has more or less ruined their life by turning them to political thuggery, and see how he can revamp them and show them a different way. He has money, so he can sponsor so many programs for them and create a better livelihood for all of them in order to regain the show. If you want to become Osho Baba again, if you doesn't want to become Osho,
you are echoing one of the slogans in Edo State, from Osho Baba to Osho Pikin. Well, yeah. That's the way it is. Losers have no, losers are like orphans. Victors have a lot of relations, fathers and sisters. Losers are just like orphans. I think of Oshomole will walk home to his mansion. And he must see, it's just like people who go to the market, he will soon discover that the market is over and people have disappeared to their homes. I'm sure
he will realize it before it's too late.
I'm sure it's not a very crowded place for Oshomole now. He must be living a very lonely life. Well, that's the way it is. Thank you for coming to for honoring an invitation into the studios. Well, viewers, that is a post-mortem of Edo State elections. Governor Obaseki came out victorious and defeated the second time around Prince Eze Iyamu. And Edo State citizens have made it clear that Edo not be Lagos, because that slogan was developed because they didn't want any godfather or somebody pushing them around to choose their leaders. They should be left alone to choose their leaders. Mr. Baduwa, I want to thank you again for coming to the program. Viewers across the world who are watching us, follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. And most sincerely, Joe Exotic, signing off on PMI Political Arena. I'll see you again. Good night.
Thank you for having me.